The first person that we have is Ashley from Steam Studios. She's a fitness expert. She's a buff to me. She's also a very beautiful person. Her personality actually shines and sparkles when she walks into a room. She did a great little fitness test last night. She got the audience really ramped up, and she, you know, her instructional videos hopefully will be coming out soon. So without further ado, let me just introduce Ms. Ashley from Steam Studios.
So today, I guess I'll just be discussing Esteem Studios, who I am, what I do, why I do it. I am Ashley Johnson with Esteem Studios that is soon to have its grand opening. And Esteem Studios will be representing dance and fitness. Hopefully, I'll create a studio that has a community environment, a family-friendly environment, where there will be kids dance and fitness classes and also adult dance and fitness classes. I am a fitness buff. I have been doing fitness for 7 years. I've been dancing for 20. And my dance background turned eventually into dance aerobics, which is how I got into what I'm doing now. So right now, the fitness industry is where my drive is, and it's where all of my focus is. Focusing in on classes, health and nutrition, kids programs, adult programs, community events, fundraisers, different things like that. Finding different new and exciting ways to expand what fitness does in the industry. What fitness is to me is a way to connect groups of people together that have the same goal in mind. Their goals might be slightly different, but they all fall under increasing health, increasing self-image, making themselves feel better, making their bodies feel better, look better. It all falls under that same umbrella. So you have groups of people from everywhere, from every background in life, even different genders. I have males and females in my classes. I have every race. I have Black, white, Asian, and Latin in my classes. And they're all from different walks of life. But the one thing that they have in common is that they're coming together to make themselves better. And what better environment than that? What better environment to bring people together to create, happiness, support, growth, health? You know, it's just a very fulfilling experience to be in the fitness industry. And thankfully, even during a recession, the fitness industry statistics have stated that the fitness industry not only stays level off, it's still, it is increasing. And fitness gyms have no issue, continuing to pull in crowds. Because at the end of the day, when people come into a fitness class and they're coming together and they are experiencing that fitness experience, that's what they keep coming back for. That's why they keep showing up on a weekly basis, because they are getting an experience, a feeling, they're getting results is the word I'm looking for. and they're walking away happy, they're walking away feeling better about themselves, they're walking away feeling better about life. So that is the main reason for me being in group exercise. There is also that one-on-one aspect, but I kind of like the idea of a group of people getting together from all different walks of life, all different backgrounds, genders, races, everything, and having a positive goal that they're trying to meet. So being a part of that is very inspiring and fulfilling for me. Was there any topics that you wanted me to specifically discuss?
Well, I think, a lot of us are busy professionals and we have to manage a lot from working to family life. So what are some advice that you can give us as to how we can balance fitness into our everyday routine?
I think the way to balance fitness into your everyday routine is to one, not see it as an option. see it as something that is necessary. Not only are you setting an example, especially if you have kids, for your kid, but you are creating a lifestyle that will ensure a longer life for you and a happier life for you. So I think the one thing, first of all, is your mental. Your mental has to change about fitness. You have to not see it as an option. Once you fix that part of it, then you need to find creative ways to make sure that you can implement it into your life schedule. Because everybody's busy. Whether you have kids or you don't have kids, whether it's work or, you know, whatever your lifestyle is, you do have to find a way to fit fitness in there. Sometimes there will be times where you might have to get on the floor at home and do some push-ups or some sit-ups. That's not, you know, really looked upon as a fun thing to do, but if you don't see it as an option, then you will find a way to fit in your schedule, whether it's before the kids wake up in the morning, before you go to work, before you go to bed, you know, something like that. The way that I suggest that you do is find a class to join. Because when you find a class to join, not only do you know that class is going to be there on a weekly basis, and you can kind of fit it into your schedule so that you know that every week at this time on this day, I'm going to be going to that class. Not only that, you will know that you have a group, a support group. That's basically what a fitness class is to me, a support group of people who are trying to reach that same positive goal. So you have a support group behind you, you got the instructor up there pumping you along, you know, you went 50% of the way, making it to the gym, joining the gym, the instructor is up there to get you along the other 50% of the way. That's what I see my job as, to get that person to reach that 100%. So I feel, you know, if you can't join a class right away, start doing something at home. You know, there's a lot of great YouTube videos out there with, you know, fitness, you know, a couple minutes of fitness a day, 10 minutes of fitness a day. I have a few YouTube videos out there myself. I don't have any DVDs yet, but that's soon to come. And, you know, find creative ways. Go on YouTube, follow that. You know, order some DVDs that you can watch at home. Add a weekly fitness class into your schedule. And another way, statistically they say, if you find a person, a workout buddy that you work out with, somebody who keeps you in check and you keep them in check, that actually keeps people in their fitness journey longer than people who just try and do it by themselves and don't have that encouragement. Because you might come from a family who you're not getting that encouragement from. You know, or you might not feel that encouragement yourself, especially when you're going through hard times. When people go through hard times, they usually do the things, they usually cut out the things that are the best for them to do. When people are going through hard times, they don't feel like training, they don't feel like working out, they don't feel like eating right. You want to eat bad, you don't want to meditate or pray, you don't want to work out, you definitely don't want to take a fitness class, because that's going to just drain more energy out of you. So I just feel like, to add on to the top of that, even when times get rough, as they will, to not cut out the things that are most healthy for you, your physical, mental, you know, spiritual health, and to just not see that as an option. Does that answer the question? Okay. Is that everything? Oh, okay.
No, well, that's not everything. Oh, okay. Because I struggle with, you know, applying the daily activity of exercise into my life. I do have two girls, and recently they've been like, "Mommy, let's go jogging."
Uh-huh.
And I'm not a jogger,
okay.
But I, you know, I see people do it all the time, and it almost inspires me to say that I can do it too.
Mm-hmm.
But how do you? I guess when you feel like you're not physically able to do it,
mm-hmm.
right? Like what? Is any advice or any tip that I can probably use on the days when I'm really not feeling up to it? Anything I can do as an alternative, maybe, as opposed to like maybe some alternatives that I can use so I can feel like, okay, well, I participated in the physical activity.
Okay, absolutely. I love that question. I actually have a blog right now. It's called ashleysfitness.blog.com. And on that blog, I list activities like that, kid healthy recipes, alternatives to fitness classes, different things like that. A couple that I can just throw at you right now. If you have kids, Kids love to dance. A good way to burn some calories and have fun with your kids is to turn on some music that they like and dance with them and burn some calories right in the living room. Have them show you, have a dance off. Have them show you a dance, you show them a dance, you know? Have a competition, you know? Make just a fun, dance night with your kids, you know? That's one thing. Another thing is cleaning your house. You burn a lot of calories cleaning your house.
And I mentioned that, I can't clean my house without music.
Yeah.
I have to have music on to clean my house.
And you should. You should. Because I feel like that music, you know, you pump up that music, you're going to be vacuuming, you're going to, before you know it, an hour has gone by and your house is clean.
So I do participate in it.
You do. You are here. So,
bad now.
Yeah, there you go. There goes two ways. Whether you have kids or don't have kids, you can find creative ways to burn calories. Matter of fact, what I might do, my next blog might be, how many calories do you burn doing this particular thing? Cleaning your house, dancing for 20 minutes, something like that. I might just make that my next blog. Because, you do burn calories doing things like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And also, I was told that if you, to strengthen certain muscles, because, you know, I still have the baby bump and I don't have baby. I was told that if you tighten your core muscles, which is, you know, your stomach area, and you do certain movements, it kind of almost can be the equivalent of doing like a crunch or a sit-up.
Oh yeah, I don't do a lot of ab crunches, but because like in Zumba class, I do a lot of things like that, that's a crunch right there, and I'm not even laying on the ground. You know, there's a lot of moves that you can do that crunch that ab area in. And getting abs, getting that definition, is not all about the exercise. It's also about diet. There's a lot of things that you can eat that sit right there. They go right there, they sit right there. Also, when you're under stress, there's a stress relief chemical in your body that's naturally released called cortisol. And when that is released, it causes you to store fat right there. So you have to make sure that you are finding ways to live a stress-free life, and also getting plenty of rest. Cortisol, when you don't get a lot of rest, cortisol also gets released in your body. When you're not getting enough hours of sleep a night, that's also a part of it. So I feel like physical fitness is a lifestyle because it is. There's things that are interconnected with it. Diet, stress, sleep, all of that. You have to manage all of that, plus your exercise, to get the results that you want. So, like I said, go to my blog. You're going to find recipes on there, kid-friendly recipes, family recipes, different things like that, that you can, make on a weekly basis. I probably have enough recipes on there for you to have 2 weeks of food. Alrighty, so all I'm saying is, just watch your diet. That's also part of the exercise regimen.
Now, what about
men?
Sorry.
No, I love this. This is good.
I tried this other fitness program, and it was great. You know, I'm pumped up, I'm excited about it. And then I woke up the next day, and I was like, oh my God, I hate that exercise. I can't do it anymore because I was so stiff. How do you work through, like, the stiffness in the body? And, you know, just so maybe you can do the exercise again, because I said, oh, I need some rest. So I did exercise for like 4 days after that just so I could recover. But I know that you're not supposed to.
Right.
Help me. How do I work through it?
Did you stretch before you went to bed to release those toxins out of your muscles?
You gotta stretch after.
Yes, you do. You have to stretch before. You have to stretch after. Because if you don't, all of that tension and all that is just held right there in your muscle. And that's why when you wake up, you feel like a robot. Like, oh my God, I can't move.
Yes.
When you stretch your body out, stretch your arms, stretch your shoulders. You know, different things like that. It releases those toxins that. I can't think of the word right now, but you have things that are held in your muscle when you do all that tense workouts, and you have to stretch that out, let it release. And then when you wake up, you won't be as stiff. Now, if you're just starting a new physical weight training workout, you are going to be stiff, but you won't be as stiff, and it won't be as painful if you stretch right before you go to bed. Yeah. And then eventually your muscles will get used to it, and then you have to change up your weight training exercises. That's another thing. If you start a weight training regimen and you're doing the same weight training regimen for, I don't know, a couple months, a month or two, it's good to confuse your muscles and switch it up so that your muscles won't get comfortable and you'll hit a plateau. If you keep doing the same exercise, you'll hit a plateau. You're like, my muscles aren't growing anymore. Or that tone isn't, you know, it's really not like that anymore. So you have to change up your weight training every so often. Yeah, every 60 days or something like that.
Mr. Freebie. Obviously, that you have recipes. So, for example, explain to us on a daily what do you eat?
Well, personally, and I don't like to tell people exactly what to eat because people have different bodies. And people also have different issues sometimes, like if you're diabetic or something like that. I don't like to tell people exactly what to eat for their body type. But for me personally, I've cut a lot of things out of my diet, like sugar. If you're a coffee drinker, you have to have your coffee. Just drink it black. You know, if you find a coffee that you really like, you know, just take the sugar out. That's just one example. I've taken sugar as much out of my diet as possible. I say I take about 90% of the sugar out of my diet. That's one. Because sugar, you should Google sugar and the side effects of it. Like, sugar is horrible for your body. So that, you know, and if you have to have something sweet, find alternatives, agave nectar or honey or something like that. I mean, it's still not good to have those types of things in large quantities, but it's still a little bit better than sugar. Also, another thing that I've started to do better with is gluten. Gluten. Gluten has a lot of bad side effects that people weren't aware of until they were. But there's a lot of gluten-free stuff, but it's become more of an awareness now than it used to be. We see a lot of gluten-free things, and that's because that wheat and different things like that have a lot of side effects on your body too. So I've taken a lot of the gluten out of my diet. Not all of it. I'm not perfect. I can't eat everything gluten-free, but I've taken a lot of that out of my diet. I've taken about 90% of the sugar. I drink more water. And I eat more meat and vegetables than anything. Growing up, my diet, you know, my mother felt that a diet should consist of starch, bread, meat, and vegetables. That was our, we always had to have those four things, no matter what. I took out the starch and the bread, and now I just eat the meat and the vegetables. And it's done a lot of wonders for my health, and my energy has increased. That's my own personal regimen. You can try it and see if it works for you. And there's nothing else.
Any other tips? Show them something that they can do sitting in their chairs, maybe? Well, for people who sit all the time behind a desk and, you know, what can they do?
Sure, I can do that. Before I do that, I do want to leave you with a few things. Please definitely visit my blog, ashleysfitness.blog.com, and that is A-S-H-L-E-Y-S, because I know there's many ways to spell Ashley. That is updated every Thursday and every Sunday. So you'll get a new blog every, and I do answer questions from real life people. If you have a question, you go on my blog, I will answer your question, I'll get back to you. Also, Ashley without an S, fitnessparty.com, which has a lot of my different fitness things that I have going on. And you can register to get email updates, inspirational quotes, daily inspirational quotes, and workout videos that I have on YouTube. So without further ado, I'll do a chair exercise, that's interesting. Anything in particular?
I don't know. What can you do in a chair?
I don't know. There's a lot of things you can do in a chair, I guess. I guess I'm not a chair exercise guru. But I don't know. I guess you can.
Maybe with a chair.
I guess there's app things that you can do with a chair. I don't know. Maybe like pulling your knees. That's a good way. Crunch while sitting down. You can pull your knees in because I can definitely feel that. So you would just point your toes, keep your legs straight, hold on to both sides of the chair, keep your abs tight, and just pull your knees in. Let it out, keep your legs straight, pull them in again. You're definitely.
Yeah, you can do a bunch of different house bars.
Like, yeah.
You know, on my favorite shows, I won't feel, you know, like I've lost any time.
Yeah.
So, it's great. Thank you so much. Yeah. And it's very important, like you said, you can do something all day and get no results. Right? You can, like, you know, you talk forever and you're not saying anything. Right? It's in the way that you do it. So when you hold in the muscle, it's like you're focusing. So the same thing when people are speaking or when you're doing whatever you're doing in your business, once you're focused, you're going to get the result. No matter what, you know, if it's, you know, a lot that you want to achieve or accomplish or just a little. It really depends on you. Because I can lay here sometimes with my belly. But if I focus and I hold on muscles in and I, you can feel it. And that's the whole point of it, being able to feel it. Work through it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because there's going to be some sacrifices to it. You're going to sweat.
Thank you.
That was wonderful.
Thank you.